We are your election headquarters, and Election Day in Illinois is now less than a week away. Tonight, an exclusive WGN-TV Emerson College poll telling us where things stand between with the big races.
Political reporter Tamon Bradley is here with the brand new numbers. Tamon.
Micah and Patrick, good evening. Here we go. This is a WGN-TV Nexstar poll of very likely Illinois Democratic primary voters. Let's begin at the top of the ticket, the race for president. By a wide margin, voter support Joe Biden over Bernie Sanders. 56.6% of Illinois voters choose Biden. 36.2% support Bernie Sanders. That support, according to our poll, is locked in. 80.7% of voters say they will definitely stick with their candidate of choice. Only 19.3% say there's a chance they could change their mind. That gives you a sense that Sunday night's debate with just Biden and Sanders might be too late to shake up the nominating contest. Let's look at the big issues in the campaign. Our poll asked voters to choose their single most important issue in settling on a candidate. Voters are looking at electability. 39.8% of voters say they want someone who can beat President Trump. 29.5% said health care was the most important issue. The economy comes in at 12.7%. Let's take a look at voters' thoughts about health care. We asked, which Democratic presidential candidate has the best health care policy? It's a statistical dead heat within our polls. Margin of error. Bernie Sanders, 50.2%. Joe Biden, 49.8%. Now, let's turn to the big money local race. Cook County State's Attorney. The incumbent, Kim Foxx, comes out on top with 36.3% of the vote. Bill Conway comes in at second with 20.3%. Donna Moore, 4.8%, and Bob Ferretti, 4.3%. But 34.2% of voters say they remain undecided. So it's anybody's guess whether coronavirus fears will impact turnout and the final results. Now, let's take a look at some other hot topics. Rod Blagojevich, we asked, do you support or disapprove of President Trump's pardoning of the former governor? 71.8% of voters disapprove, 28.2% approve. Moving on to cannabis, we asked people if they are concerned about the impact medical and recreational marijuana laws will have on their communities. 66% of voters said they are not concerned. 34% said they are. Lastly, we asked about guns, specifically Senate Bill 1966, which would increase the firearm owner's identification card fees and require fingerprinting for gun owners. 81.1% of voters in our survey support these measures. 18.9% do not. On this issue, keep in mind, this poll is a very likely Illinois Democratic primary voter. So there you go.
All right, Tamon, thank you. We're going to bring in political analyst Paul Lisnick to talk a little bit about these numbers.
Sure.
Did they surprise you?
Well, not really, but what is, look, this data was gathered over the last couple of days, and it makes me think that in these few days before the election, we're in such volatile times now, what would really impact this? So, for example, while we have, you know, Biden in the lead, certainly what that tells us is, as Tamon read us the results, is that the people who were Bernie supporters way back when. It's the people who are breaking since other things have been happening in the economy and everything else, and it appears that they likely break in Biden's way, and it supports him at 20%. On the issues category, even though the economy comes in third, healthcare is always number one with Democrats, although here it seems that getting rid of Trump is number one, which is a national kind of figure, it does raise the question, which is, as the market tumbles and tumbles, will the economy be concerned? And if it is, Bernie Sanders' healthcare proposition, which costs $32 trillion, will that weigh on people's minds in those moments before they go in and vote?
Let's talk about the Cook County State's Attorney's race. Kim Foxx in the lead there, but 34, almost 35%, if I'm correct with that,
yes.
Still undecided. Tuesday is coming up fast. What's going to happen with those people when they go in there and press that button?
You know, it suggests, look, we know Bill Conway has a ton of money behind him. I mean, there's no limit to his spending, and Kim Foxx has history. It's this Jussie Smollett thing that rides under the wave for everybody. And the question is, but there's a lot of other things Kim Foxx has done very well. That issue just pervades. So maybe that's why you see a third of the voters basically trying to weigh these issues and may not decide until the last minute how they're going to vote. But you know what? Foxx has so many endorsements behind her and the power people. That could impact certainly some of the older voters who are more maybe traditional Democrats to vote her way, but we'll see.
Certainly more to come. We thank you for your time.